The U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, is expected to release new rules governing emissions of greenhouse gases from power plants in the U.S. sometime later this spring. What the EPA's forthcoming rule does is it directly addresses emissions from fossil power plants. It does that by establishing emissions guidelines that those power plants have to comply with, essentially through naming something known as the Best System of Emission Reductions, or BSER. This Best System of Emission Reductions has to rely on adequately demonstrated technologies, and it can vary by different features of power plants. So what fuel they use, how old they are, how much they operate, and how long they plan to be around. So what EPA is expected to do and did do in its proposed version of the rule is use this Best System of Emission Reduction approach to define emissions guidelines. And then once those are in place, then the states have to step in. And what the state's role is in this process is to define a state plan for compliance with those emissions guidelines. The state is given a lot of flexibility, and expected to be so in the forthcoming rule, in terms of how states can comply with that rule. And a complication there is the fact that EPA is not expected, or is not planning, actually, to regulate existing gas plants under the rule that's coming out. Those emissions from existing natural gas plants are being held out for a future rule that will not only address greenhouse gases directly, but also address emissions of other pollutants that are of concern.